What's up, everybody? I'm Hoops and Hip Hop. With the announcement of Pokemon Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon yesterday, we got a brief 30-ish second long reveal trailer, and I wanted to go ahead and analyze it to see what the footage we were shown could mean. This list won't include any super obvious things like the new Solgaleo and Lunala forms, but will instead look at some of the smaller things you might have missed. So, without further ado, let's check it out. First off, in one of the first gameplay clips of the trailer, we can see the player running by his house, and unlike Sun and Moon where the garage to your house was closed, it's actually open this time around, and we can see a car inside. Now this might just be a decorative thing, but given that there was a considerable focus on cars in the reveal for Sun and Moon, it might mean that they have revisited that concept for Ultra Sun and Moon. We have no idea if it'll mean anything, but it's definitely something to think about. Another thing that we can see from this same clip is that this route looks much more colorful and vibrant than it did in Sun and Moon. This is a very good sign because it likely means that more areas will be updated as well, which will really help to keep the game fresh in comparison to its predecessor. It'll be interesting to see if there are any drastic changes to any previously known areas. Aside from the new Solgaleo and Lunala forms, the thing that probably stands out the most is this short sequence showcasing some sort of Pikachu sanctuary. We've got Pikachu running all over the place, and even a Pikachu-themed camping trailer is shown. It doesn't look like any place that we've ever seen in Sun and Moon before, so this could be a completely new area and could be hinting at multiple new areas to come in the games. Next up is something that may or may not be related to this Pikachu sanctuary, but it's something that kind of popped out to me. Directly after showing off this new Pikachu area, we see an angry-looking Togedemaru and Mimikyu. Now both of these Pokemon are essentially Pikachu clones, and since they're both clearly angry, it makes sense that maybe this could be related to some sort of side quest with the Pikachu Sanctuary. We already know that Mimikyu is kind of jealous of Pikachu, so a side quest like this involving the relationship between these Pokemon could be pretty cool. They could also just be totem Pokemon, but the fact that these clips came right after the Pikachu Sanctuary clips stood out to me, so take it how you will. Right after this is an epic shot of a Lycanroc jumping high into the air in front of the sun. Similar to the Togedemaru and Mimikyu, Lycanroc certainly looks like it's acting as a totem Pokemon right here, which is interesting since there wasn't a rock-type trial in Sun and Moon. This could possibly mean that there might be some shakeups to the island challenge, which would be a welcome change as we revisit the Alola region one more time. Now I mentioned that I wouldn't be discussing any of the obvious things like Solgaleo and Lunala, but there is an extra detail about the two that is definitely worth noting. Shout out to Birdkeeper Toby since he was the one who pointed this out in the first place, but even though it's clear that Solgaleo and Lunala have fused with Necrozma, they also look similar to Lusamine when she fused with Nihilego, so it'll be interesting to see if this similarity has any sort of significance once the games come out. Following up Solgaleo and Lunala, we see quite literally front and center the player character using their Z-Ring. Now this Z-Ring is definitely special and different from the Z-Rings we've seen before, because it's all black for one, and once again it's front and center during this shot. I'm pretty confident that this Z-Ring will have some sort of special ability, maybe being the thing that confused Necrozma with the two other legendaries since it matches Necrozma's appearance. We'll just have to wait and see. Now this is certainly the most insignificant detail on this list, but I thought I'd mention it anyway. When we see the player characters in their room, there are a couple of things that have changed from Sun and Moon. First, the player now has a Nintendo Switch instead of a Wii U, which makes a lot of sense, but they also have something on the table nearby that looks like an autograph or something. In Sun and Moon, there was just a Pikachu doll where this thing is now, so maybe it will have some sort of interesting description when you examine it in the game. Who knows? Like I said, I just thought it was interesting. Next is the fact that Junichi Masuda said that these games will have an alternate story to Sun and Moon. Now this could mean a bunch of different things. It could mean a more traditional approach like Platinum, where the story is simply geared more towards a different legendary, or it could be something completely different. Some people have suggested that since Sun and Moon have dealt with different dimensions, this game could take place in a different dimension to Sun and Moon. Since the story was a pretty big focus in these games, I think it will have to be significantly different, which is really exciting to say the least. And finally, this one has me pretty intrigued, and that was the mention by Masuda that there are going to be new Pokemon in this game. Now, this can be interpreted a lot of different ways. It could just mean new Pokemon, even though that's pretty unlikely, or it could mean new Ultra Beasts, Alola forms, Pokemon that weren't accessible in Sun and Moon, or simply Solgaleo and Lunala's new forms. It would be great to see something such as new Alola forms, so hopefully they don't disappoint us with this one. And there you have it, those were 10 things that you should know about the Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon trailer. I'm really glad that the hype season is back for Pokemon, and if you're as excited as I am, be sure to leave a like and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Now that we have a new game to worry about, I thought I'd give you guys a quick update on the upload schedule for this channel. The Tuesday-Saturday schedule will not be changing, but you can also expect videos on other days whenever we get new information on Ultra Sun and Moon. So just know that whenever we get new info, you can expect at least one extra new video from me, and hopefully I can put out one Ultra Sun and Moon video each week. Anyways, with all of that being said, I'll be back with another video soon, and until then, I'll smell you guys later.